At what point in time did you now start thinking about diplomacy, which was an earlier dream? Because what you had wanted coming back is achieved. You wanted the Sabataka to return his back. He's now even been coronated as a king. He has settled. Any more dreams that continued at that point?
No. But you see, the thing is, it was very, very difficult to bring back the institutions of Uganda. We found zero. And, you know, it was not just a matter, you know, there's cultural norms, there's so many things. You just don't do things. You have to find out, now, how is this done? And then you look for people to tell you how it's being done.
Mm.
Okay? So there was a lot of work to be done. But I, fortunately enough, I was not badly off financially because I had saved a little bit of money. And then also, I told you I bought a house.
In Nairobi. Which you'd used as a palace.
Yeah. Which I sold. Okay.
Mm.
And in fact, some of that money is here.
Okay.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
The only thing that I had an uncle who said to me, he said, you know, money is a bad thing to have. But once you have it, put it in something, an asset.
That will give you more money at a later
and,
stage as well.
You know, I bought 10 acres, many, many years ago. As I was telling you when we came here with Principal agent, I will tell you. So, I had a little bit of pocket money I could use, not for so much, but enough. I mean, if you translate your little dollars into
Ugandan shillings, that's some good money.
Yeah.
So fast forward. At what point in time did you join diplomacy?
Okay.
Because you were in Ethiopia, you were in Japan.
Yeah, but you see, before I joined diplomacy, there was something that I did, which I consider to be the.
You talked about Celtel.
Yeah, I started a phone company.
In Uganda?
Yeah, and out of frustration. Because when I got back here,
mm.
I could not get a phone. They told me Uganda, it was Uganda Post and Telecommunication. They said it takes four months.
To get a...
Yeah, the first of all, of course, the ministers, the big people. But when you go to me, they said, you know, I was nobody more or less.
Mm, naturally.
Yeah.
Mm.
So I said, but
that
why?
That is when you had moved from Nairobi to here?
Yes.
Okay.
And then I, what happened, by the way, I got a job, but it was with Coffee Marketing Board.
Mm.
And I was signed to go to London. But eventually, I simply said, no, I don't want to be
I
too
left
far.
To come back, and then now you're taking me too far.
I said, so for me, no. So eventually, they agreed, and they posted me at Mombasa. And I became manager there, in Mombasa. And I learned a lot about coffee, by the way, you know. And when I was tired of beans, okay, I returned here.
Mm.
And when I returned to Uganda, that's when the frustration of...
not having a phone, not being able to pick up a phone.
I mean, like, you know how it, in the States, you move into an apartment, within like hours, someone comes, you make a phone call, someone comes and hooks you up. And here I said 4 months to get a phone. But I didn't mention there's a part that you... It's worth remembering.
Mm.
When I joined the company, I worked for a company called Digital and Computing.
Mm.
And they were very, very good in technologies.
Okay.
And among the technologies they had was to work, they used to work with universities and Department of Defense, American Department of Defense. So they had this science which was not in public domain. I.e., I worked on a program that eventually became the email.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, at Stanford University. The program was called, for those who may know about it, it was called ARPANET.
Mm.
Okay? Now, ARPANET is the precursor to, okay, it was what they called data switching, packet switching, whereby you move letters from here to there.
Yeah.
Okay?
Mm.
And so I was fortunate enough to work on that program because of my communication background. Communication and technology and all that. So, while we are doing it that at the same time, they were using walkie-talkies and they were developing mobile phones, okay?
Mm.
So when I got here, and then I heard that UK had started and Sweden had started. So when this thing happened, I could not get a phone. I said, but what does
it
take?
Why don't I just get back?
Yeah, what does it take to have a phone?
Mm.
So I called a friend of mine in the States. And I told him, send me some material. I told him what I needed. So he sent me some material. I said, this is it. We start. So, on my own, I'm sitting at home. working out, figuring it out, how do I do it? Now then, when I'm almost ready, I'm told you cannot have a license because it's a monopoly of Uganda Post and telecommunication. Nobody else is allowed to do. So, by the way, I'm the one who changed the law. Yes.
So you're frustrated, you can't get a phone, you have to take 4 months. And now I can be able to do it on my own, you're saying I can't be able to do it.
So then I was frustrated, then I meet, and I give him credit for this, Dr. Colin Sentong, I don't know, you might know him, he's an economist. So I'm talking to him and he says to me, you know what, you're doing something, but I know some people who are also trying to do the same thing, why don't you guys join?
Come together.
Yeah. So he introduced me to this Asian family, the Hudani. Shiraz, he since passed. Brilliant mind, especially he was financial guru. So we meet, and so I bring my technologies to him, and he was financing. He says, okay, we can do this, we can do this. Anyway, so then I start working, but we don't have a license because the law doesn't allow us.
How did you go about that? Did you know someone who knew someone in government?
Now I'm coming. So one day, the minister of post, I don't know, telecommunication, I think it was transport and telecommunication, was Rakana Rugunda. So I meet him somewhere. I said, listen, I need to talk to you. He said, can you, okay? And yes, come to my house at 6 in the morning. So I rush his house, 6 in the morning, Colorado, and I tell him, this is what I'm trying to do. Okay? But I cannot do it because law says I can't, privately. So he said, is that what it is? He said, okay, fine. I'm going to do this. He asked me many questions because I was trying to explain to somebody nobody understands.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
I would say, listen to you. You can have this phone. You can use it. There's nowhere or nothing. And be able to talk to someone anywhere in the world. It was like something wrong with this guy. Anyway, I explained. He said, are you ready? I said, yes. So he said, okay, I'm going to introduce you to cabinet. And although I say, okay, I'm the pioneer, but I put along him along with me because he took a risk on me.
He took you to cabinet.
Yeah, he took my project to the cabinet. The cabinet agreed, okay? And I went to see him. He said, yes, we have agreed. And now there's got to be something, a white paper, something. Then later on, I ran into Mayanja Nkanji, who was the Attorney General.
Yes.
And he says, hey, kakati nogo mutamani. And it will probably see Namuna Tomanyaji. Duka, duka. To gazette it.
Oh.
He said, Mintu Michu, come in a man to not Mintu Michu, duka, duka. So I went to his chambers, wherever he was, he gave me the things.
And you
went to Entebbe for printing, government printing. And they
gazetted it.
And it became law. And this is where I become the pioneer of mobile phones.
Bringing Celtel.
Yes. So then we bring Celtel. But before we start, I had a problem because we wanted something which was very expensive. Okay. Initially, it was $8 million, and believe me, all of us combined in total, we had about $100,000.
Okay. Not even 10% of the.
Even 10%. But the thing again, I tell people: if you want something, you just believe.
And you will.
I'm going back to Mama. Believe you will have it.
Okay.
So we went. We have now a license. What do we do? And there was people looking for license to do things. So we said, okay.
And they have the money.
They have the money. And so we got one guy. And this is Mo Ibrahim. You've heard him later on.
Yes, yes.
Mo Ibrahim was already in telecoms in the UK. So someone knew him from IFC. IFC said, well, we can give you some money, but you need the technical know-how. For me, I didn't have any technology, you know, about running it.
It was just basic.
Yeah. So we flew to London. We met this Mo Ibrahim. Mo Ibrahim said, okay, for me, I'll take 10, 20%.
I give you the money.
I'll give you some money. But we need more money, 8 million. Now.
How much was he giving you? How much was Mo?
20% of that was 2.4.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay,
sure.
Million. So, Then IFC said they give us also, but they take 10%.
So that's 30.
So the money. So we're getting about closer now to 4 million. Okay. Then, but we had to get an operator to operate. The technical know-how. So Mo Ibrahim says, you know, I'll introduce you to Vodafone. Some people who have lived abroad know who Vodafone is. And so I flew to the UK and we went to meet Vodafone. Now, we are talking in the midst of raising money. Mm. And I simply say, but you see, we are now in the boardroom. Mm. And I said to these people, I said, this telephone that we are getting, the mobile, aren't it? It's an old technology. And I found out that you were using modern technology called GSM. I said, why are you giving us
old?
Why are we getting this old? Oh, he said, well, first and foremost, it's a cost. It's twice as much as you need. I said, how much is it? I say, $16 million US dollars. So I said, yeah, we should be fighting to get $16 million US dollars so that we can have fast technology. I said, see, the problem with Africa is we're always getting old stuff. If you remember later on here, people gave away their TVs, analog. And they told you, come, to give away the analog, you have to go digital. You see? So for me, that at that time, I saw something. And I said, no. And I said, this is wrong.
Okay. I will hold you right there. You've gone looking for 8 million, you already have about 4 million, and now you're thinking about 16 million.
Yes.
I'll hold 16. It just 16 million. I'll hold it just right there. Take a very short commercial break, and when we do return, we'll listen to the wrap-up conversation of this man, Ambassador Wasswa Birigwa. Let's get back.
Visit the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store to download the Afro Mobile app.